Hey, you've seen this home online, and now we're getting the story behind it.
Ashley Williams is live in South Lake Tahoe taking a look at the recently viral Mannequin House.
I have been waiting for this all morning. Hold up.
Now that I've eaten that 30 seconds of live television, yes, good morning, hanging out in South Lake Tahoe this morning. You guys, I swear to you, I got dressed this morning, arrived here, and I'm like, first of all, don't look at my, oh yeah, here we go, don't look at the socks. I'm like, I need an outfit, so thank God for the tenant here. Put me in a dress and a gown, and I snatched her wig, and I said, let's rock it for the rest of the morning.
Yes.
That is exactly what we are doing, so I'm sorry, girl, but you look good bald. So you must be wondering, what in the world is happening in this apartment complex? And we're getting ready to tell you. This is Jesse. Jesse, good morning.
Good morning.
So you are the listing agent for this particular duplex in South Lake Tahoe, which has gone viral for so many different reasons, but mainly because of the mannequins. So for starters, why did you decide to leave the mannequins up for the photos for the listing?
Well, I thought they were beautiful. I mean, at first I was shocked when I walked in because they are so lifelike. They're classic ones, so they're hand-painted and everything. And the listing actually does need a little work, some cosmetic stuff. The carpet and whatnot is old. And so I thought, let's keep the beauty and add a little lipstick to it.
Yeah.
And it's been for 16 years in real estate, this has gotten me the most play, so apparently I was doing something wrong.
lipstick, no pun intended. Okay, we'll get back to you next hour because we will take you on a tour, but let's talk about these mannequins and the man behind the mannequins. Good morning to you, Oscar Tapia.
Good morning. How are you?
Good, good. Thank you so much for letting us come in this morning.
Thank you.
Okay, so let's start about your love for mannequins. How did that start for you?
Oh, well, they mean a lot to me because, I mean, I've been collecting them for more than 20 years. So I'm really happy and proud of my vintage collection.
Yeah, so you live here right now. So you have the mannequins just placed around your house. Why do you have them out like this?
Because, I mean, I've been into these mannequins for a long time. So this makes me feel very comfortable. And then, like I say, I mean, they're part of my my everything, you know?
Yeah.
They mean a lot to me.
No, this is so cool. Oscar, we're going to hang out with you much more. So thank you so much. We're going to talk more about the gowns, guys. And specifically, Steve, come to this side. Anchors, do you know this face? Let's see if you can guess that name. And we'll give you the answer in the next hour. But so, yeah, next hour, guys, we'll do a little wardrobe change.
Okay.
We'll talk about this mannequin, talk about the importance behind all of it. But then, of course, we're going to take you on a tour of the duplex. And take you behind that door over there. Mm-hmm. I promise y'all, if you didn't think this was great, wait till you go behind that door.
Oh, snap.
Okay.
These mannequins really are gorgeous. Legit. I'm like,
they're gorgeous. They're
what?
Stunning. Yeah, and some are from the 70s, some are from the 80s, some are from the 90s. There's nothing in here that is post-2000. So that's the cool thing. So yes, more to come, guys. More to come. And I need Black Beetle. Can we please cue at some point Black Beetle?
We'll work on that. But you are working this dress.